You're watching Tag TV.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Uzma Jafri with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show with India, which has passed a historic bill to grant Indian citizenship to the persecuted minorities from its Islamic neighbors of Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan. The bill, which was passed with overwhelming majority in the lower house of the parliament, was accepted in the upper house despite numbers going against the government. A report.
The voting time starts now.
In what has been termed historic by the government of India and its allies, both the houses of the Indian Parliament passed the Citizenship Amendment Bill 2019 with overwhelming majority.
The result of the division on the motion that the bill be passed, subject to correction, ayes 125, noes 105. Abstain, 0. The motion that bill is passed is adopted.
Earlier, the bill had been passed in lower house with an extraordinary numbers 311 against 80. The bill, which was introduced with an amendment in India's 1955 Citizenship Act, grants Indian citizenship to the persecuted non-Muslim immigrants from Islamic countries of Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh. To avail the citizenship, the immigrant must be living in India since or before 31st December 2014. As perceived and propagated by the international media and organizations with vested interests, the bill neither mentions nor has any section against the Indian Muslims. The key and the sole reason behind not including Muslims from three countries is that they have Islam as their state religion and it has never been oppressed.
ये धार्मिक प्रताड़ना के आधार पर जो लोग आए हैं उनको नागरिकता देने का सवाल है यहां के माइनॉरिटी और विशेषकर किसी भी मुसलमान को चिंता करने की जरूरत नहीं है ये मैं स्पष्टता के साथ कहना किसी को भी चिंता करने की कोई आपको बरगलाए कोई डराए डरिए मत ये नरेंद्र मोदी सरकार है और संविधान के स्पिरिट के साथ चल रही है माइनॉरिटी को पूरा प्रोटेक्शन मिलेगा इसमें किसी को
While harrowing human rights violations against minorities are a regular phenomenon in Pakistan, the Taliban have meted out atrocities on minorities in Afghanistan. Indian Home Minister clarified that Bangladesh, which had an improved record in recent past, was included to cover the immigrants who had fled to India before the dawn of democracy in the country.
मैं आज इस संसद के अंदर शेख मुजीबुर रहमान के प्रति कृतज्ञता व्यक्त करना चाहता हूं कि उनके रहते किसी भी धार्मिक लघुमति के साथ अल्पसंख्यक के साथ अत्याचार नहीं हुआ और अभी-अभी जो शासन आया है उसने भी बहुत अच्छा किया
The bill has also changed the naturalization and immigration residency laws The citizenship amendment bill would not apply to tribal areas of Assam Meghalaya Mizoram and Tripura as included in 6th schedule of the constitution and the area covered under the inner limit notified under the Bengal Eastern Frontier Regulation 1873. Calling it a landmark day in Indian history, Prime Minister Narendra Modi congratulated the parliamentarians for passing the bill. The bill has been celebrated amongst the people who crossed over to India following inhuman repression by Pakistani establishment. Experts in the favor of the bill say that the Citizenship Amendment Bill would not only provide a better life to those who have been accorded a second-class treatment in their entire life, but will also further consolidate Indian stature in international arena for being more inclusive and accommodative.
Moving on, Besieged Baloch activists who are living in self-imposed exile owing to state persecution held multiple anti-Pakistan protests on Human Rights Day. The key focus of the protests, which were held in different parts of Asia and Europe, was to highlight the atrocities being meted out on Balochs by Islamabad. While on one side they asked Pakistan to stay away from their region, they also urged the United Nations to interfere in the mounting human rights violations.
Pakistan's relentless human rights violations in Balochistan to establish a strategic control in the region and exploit its resources to fill the coffers in Islamabad met another round of resistance in the form of fresh protest held across various cities of the world. From Asian city of Busan to European England and Germany, a large number of common Baloch led by activists carried out anti-Pakistan demonstrations on Human Rights Day. They chanted slogans and held banners highlighting atrocities being committed by Pakistani army and its secret agency ISI. They also underscored the role of Pakistani media, which has either self-censored itself or being instructed to not highlight the Baloch issue by the establishment.
जैसा कि आप लोगों को मालूम है कि पिछले एक दौर से बलूचिस्तान में जो ये जुल्म ज्यादतियां हो रही हैं जो किसी से ढकी छुपी नहीं है आज बलूचिस्तान में मीडिया बिल्कुल साइलेंट है और प्रिंट मीडिया में बलूचिस्तान के हवाले से कुछ नहीं बताया जा रहा है पहले बलूचिस्तान में स्टूडेंट को अदीबों को शोरा को वकला को हरिस्ट किया गया था उनको अगवा किया गया था अब नौबत यहां तक पहुंची है कि हमारे मुअज्जिब और मासूम लोगों को औरतों को बच्चों को उठाया जा रहा है
The unwritten domestic policy of Pakistan does not allow any dissent. Anyone daring to speak against the establishment is either imprisoned on trumped-up charges or abducted and killed in the line of state's kill-and-dump policy. The 2018 report of the Economic Intelligence Unit had put Pakistan in the category of hybrid regime. Baloch, however, call it an authoritarian establishment which has given an absolute authority to its army and intelligence agencies.
पाकिस्तान एक इंतहाई खतरनाक मुल्क है न सिर्फ सियासी पॉलिसी के हवाले से अपनी सियासी फॉरेन पॉलिसी के हवाले से बल्कि इंसानी हकूक के हवाले से भी आज हम एक महज़ब दुनिया में रह रहे हैं लेकिन पाकिस्तान को दूसरी जानिब ये इम्प्यूनिटी हासिल है दुनिया की जानिब से कोई प्रेशर नहीं है पाकिस्तान इस इम्प्यूनिटी का फ़ायदा उठाकर मासूम लोगों को सियासी लोगों को टीचरों को लॉयर्स को औरतों और बच्चों को अगवा करके मावराए कानून इलीगली अगवा करके उनको कत्ल कर रही है पाकिस्तानी रियासत उसमें पाकिस्तानी फौज के सरबराह से लेकर आईएसआई के आम सिपाही तक सब मुलव्वस है
As per a report by Human Rights Council of Balochistan 371 people have been abducted and at least 158 have been killed by Pakistani security forces in the first 6 months of 2019 alone. And to everybody's shock, major toll of the violence was taken by innocent Baloch women. As of March 2019, Pakistan's Commission of Inquiry on Enforced Disappearances, a state-run agency, had over 2,000 unresolved cases of enforced disappearances. It is not just the Baloch, but all ethnicities except Punjabis are having a hard time in Pakistan. Whether it is Sindhi, Pashtun, Shia, Hazara or Ahmadiyyas, Islamabad has regularly and systematically targeted each of them. Leaders present in the demonstration said that they were even being deprived of the fundamental rights.
आजादी का हक जो है वो हमारे जो है कौमी हक है, हमारा बर्थ राइट है, हमें जो है वो हक दे और हम उस हक के लिए जो है जो लोग जदोजहद कर रहे हैं उनको वो जो है डिसअपियर कर रहे हैं. अभी दो चार दिन पहले जो है एक कल्चरल इवेंट हो रहा था और उस कल्चरल इवेंट में भी जो है वो उनसे बर्दाश्त नहीं होता, उन लोगों को जो है वो उन्होंने डिसअपियर कर दिया है, लोगों को उठाकर गुम कर देते हैं. यूनिवर्सिटीज़ में फौजी ऑपरेशन हो रहा है और बलूचिस्तान की जो है वो यूनिवर्सिटियों में औरतों की यूनिवर्सिटियों में उन्होंने कैमरे फिक्स किए हुए हैं और उनकी जो है वो निगरानी कर रहे हैं इंक्लूडिंग बाथरूम्स में भी. तो ये जो जुर्म है ये जुर्म पाकिस्तानी स्टेट की तरफ से बाकायदगी से हो रहा है और उस जुर्म के खिलाफ जो है हम एहतजाज कर रहे हैं.
These persecuted ethnicities have time and again urged the United Nations and the international community to form a committee and visit these areas in order to take the stock of the situation. They have acknowledged the problem, but nothing tangible has been done on the ground to achieve some real success. And in such situation, Pakistan continues to brazenly attack the innocents, which is nothing less than a human rights situation in the country.
While almost entire Pakistan has been swept by a wave of protests seeking a set of rights to be restored for the students, the people from Gilgit-Baltistan are demanding release of political activists who have been imprisoned for many years. Release of Baba Jan, who is serving a 90-year sentence for no criminal offence, is their primary demand. People in Gilgit-Baltistan say they have not been accorded even the basic rights in seven-decade misrule of Islamabad.
Students from Gilgit-Baltistan and POK joined a student protest in Lahore to demand immediate release of political activists, including Baba Jan and his accomplices, who have been incarcerating in jail for around 9 years. Baba Jan is serving a 90-year sentence he was handed based on trumped-up charges. He's one such activist who challenged the then Pakistani administration, which was essentially working against the people of Gilgit-Baltistan.
Baba Jan aur nau sadi 9 saal se jail mein hai kisi bahar jurm ke, sirf aur sirf isliye jurm hai ki unhone wahan pe adabat jazase ke liye wo jo state ki police ki taraf se jo shoot kiya gaya tha baap aur bete ko, unke liye unke government ke khilaf wo police ke khilaf muzahira kar rahe the. 9 saal se jail mein koi sunwai nahi ho hi nahi rahi, 90 saal ki saza ho gayi hai, duniya ke kisi qanoon mein 90 saal ki saza hai? Aap mujhe ye batao, sab sare sahabi hamare samne 90 saal ki saza hui hai, wo qanoon ke kis shift mein likha hai, kaun si shift mein likha gaya, aaj tak hame pata hi nahi chala.
Pakistan establishment has overused the draconian Schedule 4 of Anti-Terrorism Act in Gilgit-Baltistan to muzzle the reasonable voices that resist its repression. It has framed dozens under the law to not only allow itself a thoroughfare in ruling the region, but also to send a threatening message across the sections of society. Locals complain that they do not have even the right to life in the region which they have prerogative over.
Hum constitutionally totally different territory hai aur us different territory mein hamare huquq khasab kiye gaye hain, talimi huquq to hame jeene ka huquq ki nahi mil rahe.
Puppet governments in Gilgit and Muzaffarabad that have largely been operating at the commands of feudal elite of Islamabad and Rawalpindi is committing systematic human rights violations to keep the people of the region suppressed and marginalized. Pakistan makes huge claims at international platforms of working in the welfare of Kashmiri people, but the ground reality reeks of a rapidly deteriorating human rights situation in the region.
Moving on to Cox's Bazar of Bangladesh, where the Rohingya refugees have found a shelter since being driven out from Rakhine State in Myanmar some 2 years ago. They all are demanding and expecting justice from the top court of the United Nations, which is hearing into the allegations of genocide by Myanmar authorities. Meanwhile, Aung San Suu Kyi, the State Councillor of Myanmar, has defended her country in International Court of Justice, saying that petitioner has placed an incomplete and misleading picture of the factual situation in Rakhine State. A report.
This group of Rohingya refugees in Cox's Bazar is watching the TV coverage of proceedings of International Court of Justice in The Hague. They are awaiting Nobel Prize winner and State Councillor of Myanmar, Aung San Suu Kyi, to speak on the crisis that brought them here in the camps. Suddenly, they all erupt in anger, as Suu Kyi has defended the actions of her soldiers and rubbished that there was any genocidal intent behind the offensive launched by her soldiers in response to the attacks carried out by Rohingya Salvation Army. They all are calling it a brazen lie.
Aung San Suu Kyi, je kotabatara Gambia.
Aung San Suu Kyi said the case brought against her country at the World Court was incomplete and misleading. She also admitted that a disproportionate force might have been used by Myanmar military, but no action was taken with the genocidal intent.
Regrettably, the Gambia has placed before the court an incomplete and misleading factual picture of the situation in Rakhine State in Myanmar.
Suu Kyi, who said that Gambia had misled the world with its version, urged the top court to drop genocide charges from Myanmar.
Myanmar requests the court to remove the case from its list. In the alternative, to reject the request for the indication of provisional measures submitted by the Gambia.
Earlier, Gambia, a small West African country with the backing of 57 members of the Organization of the Islamic Cooperation, or OIC, had filed an application before the International Court of Justice on 11th November, saying that Myanmar had violated the 1948 Genocide Convention. Gambia seeks provisional measures for the Rohingya until the case is completely solved. The ICJ orders in a case are legally binding on the parties. Twice, the talks between the Bangladesh and Myanmar governments over repatriation of Rohingya reached the final stages, but the final action could not be materialized. Rohingya expressed their 11th hour reluctance in returning to Myanmar. They demanded a home and a government job on their return, which does not look feasible to Myanmar government. As of now, the future of Rohingya is in Bangladesh only, where the government has expressed apprehensions over providing them shelter for more time.
stunning locales, breathtaking beauty, and a rich legacy of cultural heritage and tradition. This is what one gets to see in the festivals of India. These festivals not only revitalize the locals, but also offer an opportunity to every tourist to be a part of the grand celebrations. So, out of a long list of festivals celebrated in the country, today we take you to witness the extravagant three-day Kathak Utsav in Manipur's capital, Imphal. Have a look.
For past 4 years, this dance academy, named after the first Prime Minister of India, has used the cultural platform of music and dance to bring people living across different states closer. Kathak, one of the main genres of ancient Indian classical dance forms, was this year's feature. The dance, which is believed to have originated in Uttar Pradesh by traveling bards, attracts people for its unique characteristic of narrating a tale when performed. Those aware of this style find it most interesting among all dance forms. Upendra Sharma, the director of the academy and the brainchild behind this cultural exchange program, aims to connect more people to his idea.
Here also, we are celebrating this Kathak Utsav for the last 4 years continuously. And this is an exchange, cultural exchange program between the students of the two constituent units of Sangeet Natak Academy, Kathak Kendra and Jawaharlal Nehru Manipur Dance Academy. And here in this program, we have exchange program where the students of Kathak intermingles with the students of the Jawaharlal Nehru Dance Academy in the field of Manipuri dance. And they studied both the art, and then they have shared their experiences also.
It is not just the students or the Kathak enthusiasts who make an appearance during this annual affair, but renowned personalities tripping on famous renditions can also be witnessed during this 3-day long event. Audience was left mesmerized with the remarkable performance of Sameeksha Sharma, one of the leading exponents of the dance form. Students from various parts of the nation took part in the festival and performed the dance form. The program acted as a medium of cultural exchange between various states and Manipur, as performers from various states came to Imphal and learned about Manipuri culture.
एक नया experience है, learning experience है. यहाँ हमें मणिपुर के culture के बारे में पता लग रहा है. लोग यहाँ कैसे रहते हैं, क्या करते हैं, उनका basic day-to-day living कैसा है. हम सबको उसके बारे में पता चल रहा है. और हम खुद को बहुत लकी फील बहुत लकी समझते हैं हम खुद को हम सब बहुत लकी समझते हैं अपने आप को कि हम मणिपुर आए और हम कथक उत्सव का एक हिस्सा बन पाए.
Performances like these from various artists from across the states offer an insight into the subtle nuances of other dance forms, as well as provide them a platform to know more about dance forms in India.
Indian classical dancers have been truly helpful in keeping the Indian heritage of the country alive. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.
You're watching Tag TV.